It doesn't have to be loud. It can be internalized and still a powerful chai. The topic for this video is how to keep your man wild and free. When men come to me for coaching or tantric awakening, one of the things that I do is taking them into the jungle, into the river, bathing in the essence of life, so that they can reconnect with their inner life force, their inner power, the essence of their beings. Do you want your man to be wild? Do you want your man to be free? Or do you want them to be domesticated and tamed? This is a special message for you women out there, because I want you, just for a minute, to take a moment to realize that the impact, the influence that you have over the man that you love, that you care for, the man in your life, your brothers, your lovers, your husbands, your partners, your boyfriends, you have an incredible power of influence over their lives. Because through the sharing of sexual energy, through the sharing of connection, time, space, together, through conversations, through emotions, you have the power to incredibly impact how a man is going to feel about himself. And so my question to you is very simple. How do you want him to feel? What are the emotions that you want to trigger in him? What are the qualities you want to activate in him? You are a potential coach in his life. You can be an empowering agent in his life. Do you want your man to be wild and free? And if the answer is yes, but that's a bit scary, then take a moment just to feel into this. Take a moment to feel how it impacts on your energy to actually be an agent of growth and evolution in your man's life. What role do you want to play in your man's evolution? Do you want to limit his growth within the sphere of your agenda, or do you want to expand him, open space around him so that he can grow to its full potential? Do you want your man to be domesticated and tamed after 2-3 years of marriage? Or do you want him to be able to access his wild side, his inner power, his strength? I'm not here to judge you or to tell you what to do, okay? Let's be very clear about this. Each woman chooses how she relates to the men in their lives. And that choice, I fully respect it. I'm not here to judge or to tell you what to do. What I'm giving you here is options, perspectives. And then from within these perspectives, you can choose what works for you. It's very simple. It is your choice and it is fully your responsibility, because I trust that from within, you can tune in and identify exactly where your truth is. How do you relate to the man in your life? Are you an empowering agent that expands them? What kind of qualities do you bring in them? How do they feel when they are around you? Are they expanded? Are they tapping into their potential? Are they tapping into their universal identity, their divine nature? Or are they contracting, becoming smaller, tamed, scared, or afraid? You know, what is the impact that you have in a man's life? And you can be a coach for a man. You can be the woman who is going to cheer him up, expand him, and help him grow. So this idea of man being wild and free, right? Where does that come from? Well, it's going back to the warrior nature. It's going back to this fully empowered human being and mature human being that you want to have in your life. Very often, when a man enters into a relationship or with you or becomes your lover, you will be attracted to the raw side. You will magnetically be pulled into his life because there is something so authentic and so true about him. And so very often what tends to happen is that there is a domestication process that happens in this relationship. And then you look at the man that you used to love 5 or 10 years later, and this man is no longer what he used to be. He has lost something, some form of power, some form of passion about his life, some form of life force. It's not always like that, but that's an option, that's something that can often happen. And so what I encourage you to do is really check into the role that you're playing in his life and what kind of role do you want this to be. I'm not against domestication or influence. I'm not against you educating your partner. These are very positive qualities. Actually, to be able to function together as a couple or as a family, you need to have some influence on each other. You need to be able to tell your man, your husband, or your partner, hey, when you do this, it's actually hurting me. You need to have a safe space to offer each other feedback, to tame each other, to influence each other. The question is, how much of that do you need in a relationship? In my experience, a couple can take maybe 5 to 20% of educating or taming, influencing on each other. 80% of your couple space, at least, needs to be about fun, connection, trust, spontaneity, you know, freedom. Those qualities need to be very present in your couple space. If most of the conversations are about, you know, how to contract each other in the relationship, that's not going to work. If a man has very little space for freedom and expression, eventually, what will he do? He will run away to reclaim his freedom. The only way for couples to stay together, for two lovers, for two partners to stay together on the long term, is if the space of the relationship is spacious enough to allow deep, profound evolution, deep, profound manifestation of your full potential. So lately I'm talking a lot about the wild women, right? Men helping women or being agents or simply holding space for women to express their wild nature, right? A woman going wild, a woman being expanded is beautiful. And we as men, we want to play a role. We want to hold space for that expansion. So the question is, how does it work the other way around? Do women go wild and men stand there, you know, as witnesses without really moving energy in the same way? No, not at all. Women are mirrors to men. Men need those qualities as well. We want to expand. We want to grow. We want to be wild. We want to be able to tap into that. And the magic is that when a man is with a woman who is spacious enough to allow that expansion, the man comes back to her because the relationship that he has with that woman is based on love and trust. It's not based on contraction and control. If a woman comes into my life and sets me free, what do you think I'm going to do? I'm going to want to spend more time with this woman. I'm not going to run away. Once a woman is an empowering agent in my life, of course I'm going to stick around. Of course I'm going to want to spend more time with her. And so this idea that the moment you set a man free, he's just going to run away, that's not true at all. In my experience, it's actually the opposite. I've been in a 10-year relationship with a woman and we were completely free. The control patterns were not very present. we were setting each other free. And the reason why it lasted so long is because we were committed to give each other freedom. See how it works? I know it's counterintuitive, but the idea is release control, you know, let go, expand, and you will see what happens. And if, you know, you cannot fully tune into it, just get in touch. You know, go to vitalcoaching.com and check what I do, sign up for some coaching sessions or something like that. But what I want to tell you is that we are now in a place in our human evolution as couples, as lovers, where we need to integrate new codes of relating and helping your man be wild and free. I think it's one of the core codes that needs to wake up in our consciousness. I hope that makes sense to you. I love you very much. And to your couple, to your beauty, to your joy, to your sex life, I really hope that you expand within that space. I'll see you soon.